Tens of millions of people have read the hadiths, among whom were and are Western luminaries on the subjects of the Quran and the Arabic language. But no one that I know of has addressed the issue of how Muhammad calculated the measure of distances. Muhammad, the alleged greatest and most knowledgeable of all the previous prophets, measured distances in terms of days, weeks, months, or years. Let us together explore the following hadith that will demonstrate what I'm trying to tell you. Al-Tirmidhi 5735, narrated by Abu Huraira. While Allah's Prophet and his companions were sitting, clouds came over them and Allah's Prophet asked, "Do you know what these are?" On their replying that Allah and his messenger knew best, he said, "These are the clouds. These are the water carriers of the earth, which Allah drives away from people who do not thank him or call upon him." He then asked, "Do you know what is above you?" On their replying that Allah and his messenger knew best, he said, "It is the firmament, a ceiling which is guarded and waves which are kept back." He then asked, "Do you know what is between you and it?" On their replying that Allah and his messenger knew best, he said, "Between you and it are 500 years." He then asked, "Do you know what is above that?" On their replying that Allah and his messenger knew best, he said, "Two heavens with a distance of 500 years between them." He went on speaking like this till he counted seven heavens, the distance between each pair being like between heaven and earth. He then asked, "Do you know what is above that?" On their replying that Allah and his messenger knew best, he said, "Above that is the throne, and the distance between it and the seventh heaven is the same as that between each pair of heavens." He then asked, "Do you know what is below you?" On their replying that Allah and his messenger knew best, he said, "It is the earth." He then asked, "Do you know what is under that?" On their replying that Allah and the messenger knew best, he said, "Under it, there is another earth with a journey of 500 years between them." And so on, till he had counted seven earths with a journey of 500 years between each pair. He then recited, "He is the first and the last, the outward and the inward, and he is omniscient." So-called believers and unbelievers, have you noticed how Muhammad's followers, the gullible, superstitious and unlearned, kept answering his questions with the mantra of "Allah and his messenger know best"? Muhammad also asserts that Allah is omniscient. Furthermore, have you noticed the repeated measurement of 500 years distances? As nomadic cameleers, the Arabs measured distances by the time it took a camel to cover a day's journey. Nobody asked Muhammad at what rate of speed these distances were measured, presumably because they understood it to be the average of a day's travel by camel. Most important of all is that we are made aware that Allah knows what Muhammad knows. But what Muhammad knows is all wrong. So how is it logical or possible that if Allah is the same as the omniscient God of Israel and Jesus, can he be so much in error? This is utter blasphemy. Can any of you so-called believers give us a logical explanation? Sahih al-Bukhari 9.519, narrated by Abu Huraira. The Prophet said, "Whoever believes in Allah and in his apostle, offers prayers perfectly and fasts in the month of Ramadan, then it is incumbent upon Allah to admit him into paradise, whether he emigrates for Allah's cause or stays in the land where he was born." He further added, "There are 100 degrees in paradise which Allah has prepared for those who carry on jihad in his cause, jihad fi sabilillah. The distance between every 2 degrees is like the distance between the sky and the earth. So if you ask Allah for anything, ask him for the Firdaus, for it is the last part of paradise and the highest part of paradise. And at its top, there is the throne of the beneficent, and from it gush forth the rivers of paradise." As we have demonstrated in our chapter 79, Fall of Adam, Muhammad's paradise is a replica of the Bible's Garden of Eden, except that he erroneously transferred it to Allah's heaven and turned it into a physical and not a spiritual abode. Al-Tirmidhi 5632, narrated by Abu Huraira. Allah's messenger said, "There are 100 graves in paradise with a distance of 100 years between every two." Please notice that according to this hadith, the distance between the sky and the earth is equal to 100 years and not the previous 500 years. Al-Tirmidhi 5681, narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, the Prophet said, the awnings of hell have four thick walls, each wall a distance of 40 years. Al-Tirmidhi 2064, narrated by Abu Umama, Allah's Messenger said, if anyone fasts for a day while on jihad, Allah will put between him and hell a ditch as wide as the distance between heaven and earth. Sahih al-Bukhari 9.502, narrated by Abu Huraira. The Prophet said, Allah says, I am just as my slave thinks I am. That is, I am able to do for him what he thinks I can do for him. And I am with him if he remembers me. If he remembers me in himself, I too remember him in myself. And if he remembers me in a group of people, I remember him in a group that is better than they. And if he comes one span nearer to me, I go one cubit nearer to him. And if he comes one cubit nearer to me, I go a distance of two outstretched arms nearer to him. And if he comes to me walking, I go to him running. Muhammad's Allah looks upon his creation as slaves. As we all know, there cannot be any love between a slave and a slave master, only fear. That is why Muhammad's cult belief system is based entirely upon terror, fear, subjugation, and submission, without a drop of love, salvation, or redemption. Sahih al-Bukhari 8.559a, narrated by Abu Huraira, the Prophet said, the width between the two shoulders of a kafir, disbeliever, will be equal to the distance covered by a fast rider in 3 days. Sahih al-Bukhari 7.221, narrated by Sahil bin Sa'ad al-Sa'idi, Allah's Apostle, holding out his middle and index finger, said, my advent and the hours are like this. Namely, the period between his era and the hour is like the distance between those two fingers, i.e. very short. As usual with Muhammad's prophecies, not one of them came true, and most certainly this one regarding the end of days. Sahih al-Bukhari 4.391, narrated by Abdullah bin Amr. The Prophet said, whoever killed a person having a treaty with the Muslims shall not smell the smell of paradise, though its smell is perceived from a distance of 40 years. Sahih al-Bukhari 4.93, narrated by Abu Sa'id. I heard the Prophet saying, indeed, anyone who fasts for one day for Allah's pleasure, Allah will keep his face away from the fires of hell for a distance covered by a journey of 70 years. Sahih al-Bukhari 1.429, narrated by Jabir bin Abdullah. Allah's Apostle said, I have been given 5 things which were not given to any amongst the prophets before me. These are, Allah made me victorious by terror for a distance of 1 month's journey. The earth has been made for me and for my followers a place for praying and a thing to perform tayammun. Therefore, my followers can pray wherever the time of prayer is due. The booty has been made halal, lawful for me, and was not made for anyone else before me. Every prophet used to be sent to his nation exclusively, but I have been sent to all mankind. I have been given the right of intercession on the day of resurrection. Sunan Abu Dawood 3091, narrated by Anas bin Malik. The Prophet said, if anyone performs ablution well and pays a sick visit to his brother Muslim, seeking his reward from Allah, he will be removed a distance of 60 years from hell. Sahih al-Bukhari 2.423, narrated by Abu Huraira. The angel of death was sent to Moses, and when he went to him, Moses slapped him severely, spoiling one of his eyes. The angel went back to his Lord and said, you sent me to a slave who does not want to die. Allah restored his eye and said, go back and tell Moses to place his hand over the back of an ox, for he will be allowed to live for a number of years equal to the number of hairs coming under his hand. So the angel came to him and told him the same. Then Moses asked, O my Lord, what will be then? He said, death will be then. He said, let it be now. He asked Allah that he bring him near to the sacred land at a distance of a stone's throw. Allah's Apostle said, were I there, I would show you the grave of Moses by the way near the red sand hill. Dear listeners, as we have demonstrated conclusively in several of our chapters and based entirely upon the very Arabic records passed on to us by the Muslim exegetes, Muhammad was a pathological liar who contorted, twisted, and deformed theology, history, biblical stories, time, and place. We would like to emphasize the obvious, that these records were not transmitted or written by the alleged enemies of Muhammad, such as Western imperialists, Christian evangelists, Zionist Jews, Hindu or Buddhist kuffar, but by his own Muslim followers.